That was the title track from their album called A Jacket of Batteries. The Shadowland are a band who've been together for a few years, but the thing is that at the end of this week, they're not going to be around as the Shadowland anymore. With us now from the band, Lee James and Rod Spark. Hi.
Hi. Hi there.
What's the story behind this?
Well, I think there's
several reasons.
Several reasons, all of them amicable. But the band's been together now for about 4.5 years, and despite considerable what could be termed success, we've decided that it's probably the end of the road and best to go out on a bit of a high rather than to let things dwindle downwards.
You're an Edinburgh band, of course, but you've currently got a recording contract with a German company.
Yeah, Twist Records.
How come no action in your homeland?
It seems to have been a feature of the way we've progressed over the years that our fan base, if you want to call it that, has been primarily continental. It's quite strange that we can wander around quite unrecognised in our hometown, whereas possibly some cities abroad we're regulars on the music press and so on. So that's one of the frustrations that has sort of come together to enable this decision of ours.
What's been the biggest successful place for you so far? Has it been Germany or where?
I don't know, possibly Italy. We've actually had a Christmas number one last year with our Smoke EP.
You mean you were the equivalent to Mr. Blobby?
Well, perhaps not visually.
I certainly hope not. No. Christmas number one in Italy, and of course there's going to be some releases in Japan soon as well.
That's right. There's a Japanese publisher called Sun Kyo who are securing, as we speak, the rights to the first LP, Kaleidoscope, for release on CD format in and around Japan. So that's quite exciting.
And this track that we're going to play now, She, this is lifted from a DAT copy of your mini album that you sent through to us, but is also a single, but in a kind of different mix, I'm told.
Yeah, it's a different mix. The single should be out hopefully for the gig. The last gig was on the 27th of January at Murray House, and it is a different mix, slightly. It's actually our mix, isn't it?
Yeah.
We didn't like the producer's mix as much as we could have, as much as we liked the B-side.
Well, as far as gigs left for the Shadowland to play are concerned, apart from Murray House, any other stuff? Give us a rundown of what's going to be happening for the band.
One more gig at the Subway in Edinburgh on the 20th of January.
Yeah.
We're still currently recording our final single entitled The Leaves and Superstar, and our C single, like I said, should be out the end of January, and I think that's about it.
And what happens to...
Oh, and another single, yeah, actually on a British label, probably going to be Paradise and Introducing Mr. Sun, two old tracks.
Okay, and what happens to the people in the Shadowland after that time?
Well, Lee and I have got a new band together, as yet untitled, doing sort of late 60s, early 70s instrumentals in a jazzy vein. I'll probably continue producing to a small extent, possibly some session work in the Hammond. And I'm actually in the UK version of Tommy as well, the Who's Tommy.
Oh, yeah.
And as it enters its 25th year, we'll be doing all the anniversary gigs in London, etc. Possibly some gigs in France. And possibly another stint at Edinburgh Festival.
Oh, well, keep us up to date with what you're doing as we go along. Shadowland, Lee and Rod, thanks for that. We'll play out now with She.
This is a test of the emergency broadcast system. Had there been an actual emergency, your local station, in conjunction with the relevant federal authorities, would have broadcast the following pre-recorded announcement.
Welcome to the Groovesound's latest release. You're listening to the sound of the Shadowland. This record contains previously unreleased material and an exclusive preview.
Shadowland, their single called She, and if you're not too careful, it segues onto the next track in the album, so we shall fade that out before they get away with an extra song and two for the price of one. Anyway, King Tut's Wawa Hut in Glasgow, they're continuing with this.